Hey, I'm Scott Hanselman. It is Azure Friday. We're here with Steve Michelotti talking about Azure Government. What's that?
That's the question everyone asks, and it's important to answer that question first.
I'm like, wait, what?
So if I were to answer what Azure Government is in one sentence, I would say that it's a sovereign cloud that's dedicated to U.S. government workloads only. And when I say U.S. government, I don't just mean the federal government. Mm-hmm. This could be state and local governments, public sector.
Could it be my town?
Potentially, yes, absolutely. And then the other question that always comes up, well, what do I mean by sovereign cloud?
Yeah.
Basically, what we're talking about here is it's a physically isolated instance of Azure. So normally think of Azure as this worldwide cloud that has data centers in multiple continents.
Dozens of data centers, and they're all interconnected.
Exactly. In this case, we're talking about data centers that are physically isolated from the rest of Azure, no connection to Azure Commercial whatsoever.
Really?
And the data centers are in the United States, continental United States only, and they are operated by screened U.S. persons only. Mm. And that's the thing that gives us a higher level of compliance than commercial Azure. So, for example, we have DISA Level 5, which is a DOD Department of Defense certification. That's like one of the highest certifications you can get for unclassified workloads.
Right.
Azure Commercial can't get that because they're in other countries and data sovereignty rules where the data has to stay in the continental United States.
Ah.
But because we are isolated data centers, isolated network, that enables us to get the higher levels of compliance. Even though it's the same technology.
Okay, so this isn't like a section of an existing public data center. It's not a shed that's like on the sidecar. These are physically different buildings.
Absolutely.
Different people working there.
Yes.
And the data always stays inside of the U.S.?
Correct.
Is it U.S. specific? Because
yes.
I know Germans like their things separate. Other countries like China might want their own. Are those instances of Azure?
That's absolutely correct. So we have some other national clouds, other sovereign clouds, but with this one, this is just U.S. government only.
So then I assume that each cloud, each sovereign cloud, then meets the standards required by the U.S. government or the Chinese government or
exactly, whatever their country's requirements
are. Our U.S. one has requirements for you know, it needs to be physically isolated, U.S. persons doing the work.
Exactly.
And
exactly.
You know how we always say, oh, you know, I'm going to buy this car and it's military grade. It's
right.
A Hummer, military grade.
Yeah.
Is this a Azure with more screws tightened?
Right. So it's the same underlying technology under the covers as regular Azure. It's just that because we have these physically isolated data centers with the screened U.S. Mm-hmm. persons working them, that is what enables us to get the higher levels of compliance.
Okay, so this is the Azure I know. Like, I know this already.
Yes.
I didn't know it existed until just now, but I still know it. I can log into the portal.
Exactly.
I can use the different command lines and talk to this thing.
It's exactly.
My Azure, VMs, websites, all that.
Right. Yeah. And the data centers we keep talking about are right here. Our original data centers are east and central, mm-hmm. and then we added two more data centers also located east and central, but these are different because these are DoD data centers that have even higher levels of compliance. And then we have these other two data centers coming in 2017. So these six data centers gives us six times more data centers than our closest competitor in the government cloud space. And then in addition to these data centers, we also have express route locations that are dedicated to government. They're not piggybacking on our commercial infrastructure, dedicated fiber, which the express route, of course, is the technology that enables you to get the private connection from your data center into the cloud.
Right. We did a bunch of shows on hybrid networking and how express route works, so people can check those out as well.
Exactly.
So this kind of is meant to assuage or to calm down anyone in government who is concerned about where their data
yes.
goes, who has access to their data, and whether it might leave the country.
Exactly.
And when you said DoD, that stuff is like Azure Government Plus?
Well, it's just the extra levels of compliance in terms of how the data centers are managed and who's working them. That's
very cool.
Okay. All right, so what I want to show is a series of demos,
mm-hmm.
and the demos are going to be from a developer perspective, and you're going to see a common theme through all these demos.
Okay.
And that common theme is you have to know the little tweak to get connected to Azure Government, so you as a developer must know how to connect,
mm-hmm.
but once you connect, you're going to have the same developer experience that you have with regular commercial Azure.
All right. That's it.
So let's start with the absolute most basic concept here, which is logging into the portal. And what you're going to see when you log into the government portal is it's portal.azure.us. Normally you go to azure.com, but it's portal.azure.us. And you'll also see the title here is Microsoft Azure Government. So if you see these two things I've highlighted, you've successfully logged in to Azure Government.
Oh, interesting. And then this is a small point, but I'm noticing
right.
Map
no data centers over
There's
here.
There's no data centers in Europe. There's no data centers
exactly.
in Canada.
And this also, the fact that it's a different URL also brings home the point it is a different you know, it's a different data center, we have different endpoints, and that'll be
Azure.
A common theme. But
Azure.
Once you get connected, the experience is the same. So for example, if I click on app services, I have a couple of websites. There's Azure Friday Gov,
right.
which has a URL, and the URL is Azure Websites. .us
it's not
by default.
.net.
Exactly. So of course you can add a custom domain if you want,
sure.
but by default it's a .us. And even the experience to provision a website is virtually identical. There's just a slight difference, which is that when you go to actually provision the app right here, mm-hmm. let's just give it a quick name. I just want you to see how the experience is the same. We'll just call this AZ Friday,
okay.
and we'll put it in a new resource group called AZ Friday.
Okay.
And what you're going to see here is that when I go to create a new app service plan, you're going to see that, I'll just call this test, in the location, we don't see all these data centers from all over the world.
Right.
We just see US Gov Virginia or US Gov Iowa.
Oh.
But other than that, the experience is the same. I'll click create, although I'm not going to wait around for the 15
sure.
seconds for it to provision.
Well, so, I mean, help me understand this, though. Who pays for it? If I'm on some of the council things in my town. If small town Oregon
yep.
wants to start running their websites on Azure Government,
yes.
who signs up and puts in their URL, their email, and their credit card?
Absolutely. So that's a good question, which is if you go to azure.com/gov, mm-hmm. you can sign up for a trial, but we vet everyone that comes in. I don't know if it's extreme vetting, but we vet everyone that comes in, and we verify that they are, in fact, associated with a government.
Uh-huh.
Once that verification process happens, you have an Azure subscription, just like regular Azure.
And they can pay, like a small municipality could pay with the credit card that
Absolutely.
They use to pay for stuff.
Sure.
Okay.
Okay, so the next thing I want to show is how to connect to the Azure command line, Azure CLI.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to show Azure CLI 2.0.
Yeah.
You could do what I'm about to show. You could do similar with our PowerShell modules as well.
Okay.
And you can do any shell you want, SQL, cmd.exe. I'm going to use Commander. And actually, before I show you how to connect to Azure Gov, what I want to do is I'm actually already connected to Azure Commercial right here.
Okay.
And I want to run this command account list locations.
So you do the traditional AZ login.
Exactly.
And logged into your
And we have data centers from all over the world.
Right.
So now I'm going to run this command AZ cloud list. And this is a command a lot of people may not know
wow.
what it is.
Different clouds.
Why would I ever list clouds? I thought there was
Germany.
Only one cloud.
There's
exactly.
Germany.
If I scroll up, what I'm going to see is there is Azure US Government right here.
Okay.
And oh, by the way, we have different endpoints, core.usgovcloudapi.net,
right,
driving
right.
home the point.
The gallery's in a different place.
Exactly.
The management API, it's entirely separate.
Exactly. So now what I can do is cloud, AZ cloud set, and I have to change the context. So we're pointing to Azure US Government. Make sure I spell that right.
That's not hard.
Now that I'm pointing to Azure US Government, I'm going to hit the up arrow twice to get that AZ cloud list. We're going to run it again, except this time we're going to say output table. And instead of that big JSON dump, we see output table and Azure US Government. Now the is active flag is set to true because I just did AZ cloud set. So now that we're pointing to US Government, now it's traditional AZ login. I can give it a username. And my username, and then I can give it my password. And this is a traditional.
How did you do that cool?
So I just use an auto hotkey snippet. So
yeah.
I can just, I didn't want to type in my long
URL.
So I put the password in and I get connected. And now what I'm going to do, you can see I have a default subscription. I'm going to hit the up arrow again.
Right.
And I'm going to go back to the command I previously ran, list locations.
Right.
The last time I ran this, it gave me the list of all these data centers across the world.
There it is.
And now this time when I run it, I'm seeing just the data centers in Azure Government, further proving I'm connected.
Oh,
and once
I didn't even know it shows latitude and longitude. That's kind of cool.
And once I'm connected, now it's just the same developer experience. So I can come in here, easy, app service, web list, and now my developer experience is just the same as if I was using regular Azure Commercial. I see my Azure Friday website that I just provisioned, and
so if
it's all
people
right
are watching and they are Azure developers now, and then they decide to go and get a government contract and
yep.
work for the government, they know this stuff.
Exactly.
They
exactly right. So continuing on with that, I want to bring up the Azure Storage Explorer, and what we have here is, you know what? Let me just do a fresh instance here. I want you to see this happen from scratch. And so here I have this empty instance
right.
of the Azure Storage Explorer. And this is a tool that if you're an Azure developer, you probably already know it
well. StorageExplorer.com.
It's free. Exactly. It's free. It's cross-platform. It's very easy to use.
Mm-hmm.
But what we're excited about is now it has a new feature where it natively connects to Azure Government. So I come in here and add an account. The first question it'll ask me is, well, what environment do you want to log into? And now there's a choice here for Azure Government. So now it's just, again, a small nuanced difference on how I connect. And once I do that, there's my little snippet again.
That moment there.
Once I connect, now my developer experience is going to be just the same as it always is as a regular Azure developer. I just have to know that I have to flip that connection. And I have these storage accounts already mm-hmm. provisioned in my subscription. You can see I've got some blobs, mm-hmm. some queues. I have a table called contacts right here. If I click on it, we can see that I've already got a couple rows in the table, first name, last name, Joe right. Blow, Jay Doe. And you can also see that the URL for that, again, there's contacts. But just to drive home the point, I have table.core.usgovcloudapi.net.
So different URLs for every service.
Exactly.
But it's still an instance of Azure.
Yep.
My existing code that I've written custom code that talks to REST APIs, as
yes.
long as I'm aware that I'm talking to Azure Government versus public right. Azure, that code will work.
Absolutely. And you brought up code. And so I've shown you how to connect to the CLI and the portal. But the final demo I want to show is, so I'm a C# developer. And so if you're a C# developer, maybe I'm using a C# SDK for Azure. How do I connect that and point my code to Azure Government? So let's flip over here to Visual Studio. And first off, what we're going to see is I just have this snippet of code right here.
Right.
And this is just completely boilerplate code. Nothing interesting about this code. If you've written against the storage APIs, you've written code like this.
Right.
Create a client, get a reference to that contacts table. I've hard-coded that GUID for Joe Blow, mm-hmm. I execute it, and then we display the results.
Yes.
Nothing interesting about that, completely
non-cloud
boilerplate.
Non-cloud specific.
That's copy and paste from documentation, practically.
Okay.
What is different is that if we look at the line of code before that, we have the constructor for the cloud storage account, and you notice that the second parameter we're sending in here is core.usgovcloudapi.net. And a lot mm-hmm. of developers may not even know this constructor exists, because they always use the default.
Right.
Or maybe they saw and they wondered, what is this constructor with the endpoint suffix?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is why it's there. It's
so
you can redirect.
How would I know that URL? Docs?
Yes. And actually, when I ran the command line, mm-hmm. remember it showed all the URLs?
Oh, they were in there.
So you don't even have to go to the docs, although we do have them
sure,
there.
Sure, sure.
But you can just grab it from PowerShell or the CLI and it'll show the URL. So that's the one line of code you have to know to change as a developer. And then your developer experience is exactly the same. And let's just do Control F5 to prove it, that we can go and actually query
Boom.
Storage. And there's Joe Blow that we were just looking at in Storage Explorer a second ago. So again, the key theme here is that as a developer, you just have to know the one little tweak to connect.
Mm-hmm.
Once you're connected, you can use the tools that you're familiar with, the tools that you know and love.
Very cool. I have just discovered that I know how to code to the Azure Government Cloud.
That's right.
Here on Azure Friday.